Hey everybody, this is Pastor Dan with your High Five. Hopefully this will be encouraging and equipping for you. This week we're talking about marriage. Yes, marriage. We're talking about wonderful marriage on Friday. My wife and I, November the 20th, we'll be celebrating our 16th anniversary. Ephesians 5:25 encourages us as it says, however, let each of you love his wife as himself and let the wife see that she respects her husband. Marriage is great. It truly is. There's a lot of awesome things. You've got a life partner with you. You get somebody that will help you grow and help you mature to become more like Christ, someone that loves unconditionally, that you can endure and go through life with and just continue to be in love with. But just as marriage is great, marriage is also a challenge, very much so, because again, it says for the husband to love his wife in Ephesians 5:25, it says, husbands, love your wife as Christ loves the church. It also says in 5:22 for wives to submit. And then you go all the way down to 33 is to respect, right? So for wives, their challenge is to respect us husbands and to and also to submit to us. That sounds very challenging because one, as a guy, I know how sinful I am and how challenging that is. And to think that that is the standard for our wives is something that's going to be quite a bit of a challenge. What was also a challenge is to love our wives as Christ loved the church. It doesn't say just love your wives. It says love your wives as Christ loved the church. That creates an ironing, sharpening iron going on. You know, for men, there's this natural desire for respect. For women, there's this natural desire for love. And understanding those two very different things is crucial in any marriage. I want to share with you some mistakes that I've made, certainly in my marriage over the course of the last 15 plus years, going to be 16 in just a few days. And one of those is Christ not being the center of the marriage. If Christ is not the center, then there is no standard. There is no balance. There is no platform to go back to. All right. So if Christ is not the standard, it's going to fall apart, because if your standard is just wanting to have a great marriage, well, you're never going to have a great marriage outside of Christ. He is the being in which he makes that happen. And if Christ is the center, those are those times where you're wrestling. Do I want to forgive? Do I not want to forgive? If Christ is the standard and he is the center, all right, then the choice has already been made. It's just a matter of whether we're going to be obedient to what we've been asked to do. And as a reflection of that, when Christ is not the center, also, in addition to, our marriage is not a reflection of the gospel. And I believe that's why he says in 5:25 of Ephesians, for husbands to love your wives as Christ loves the church, because it is a reflection of the gospel. Our love for one another reflects God's love for us, a selflessness love, a love that was willing to die and lay down one's life, a love that was continually searching and going after. We've got to see our marriage as a reflection of the gospel. And linked into that is seeing our marriage as the outflow of our ministry. And so much mistake I've made, at least, is you do, and you're doing for more outside the home than you are within your home. And ministry, especially those of us that are in the ministry or pastors, we struggle with that balance of serving this church that has a lot of needs. And yet sometimes we can easily neglect our family, forgetting that our family, especially our marriage, we should do ministry out of an outflow of that marriage. And then next, I'd say the self-centeredness, the looking into marriage is getting it for oneself. That's where you begin to count things like, well, it's your turn to do this. It's your turn to do that. If there's not a Philippians 2:4 mutual interest, wanting to serve one another, it's going to be a challenge to have a healthy marriage. In fact, I'm going to say you're not going to have a healthy marriage because marriage truly is about trying to serve the other. All right. If you're constantly looking for your own interest in marriage, it's going to be very disappointing for you, because marriage challenges our selfishness more than anything else. And then you add kids to the element, very challenging. And I think that's why God instituted the family for that purpose, is to, it is a form, it is a construct to conform us into his image. If you're doing marriage and you strive to have a great, healthy, Christ-centered marriage, it's going to cost. Absolutely, it is going to cost. And then last thing I'd say is putting kids before your marriage certainly becomes one of a big challenge for anyone that has children, making the kids the priority. It sounds good and it sounds exciting, but what often happens is the marriage is neglected. And you're only the best mom, you're only the best dad when you are the best husband and you are the best wife. And so those demonstrations have to be at the center. And I've made all of these mistakes that I just shared with you. And I just pray this encourages you. If God has brought you to a marriage, I encourage you to seek his will and seek his word on how you are to love. So next week, I want to talk about some things that we can do well. This week is a lot of pitfalls that I've made. And hopefully next week will be an encouragement. So we're praying for you. The holidays can be incredibly stressful on marriages. So let's get through these holidays whole and healthy with our spouse. God bless y'all. We look forward to seeing you next time on High Five.